In this video, you're going to learn how and why you might want to implement a dynamic column selector for your interactive dashboards. If you're new to this channel and you're keen to learn the latest tips, tricks, and tools for working more effectively with data, please hit the subscribe button for weekly videos. So in my last video, I went over this example here on how to build a dynamic filter. And if you haven't seen this yet, you can go ahead and check that out. All of this is part of my course, Our Shiny Flex Dashboards and Interactive Data Visualizations. And these questions here were basically inspired by some of the great questions which are coming through from some of my students. So in this example today, I'm going to go over how to build this dynamic column selector. So here we have a data set and it has a number of columns. Now, a lot of time when you're doing data analysis, sometimes you end up with many more times columns than this. And you end up with too many columns that you can see on the screen. Now, you could basically subset the columns so you're just seeing less columns. But the problem with that is that maybe you just want to see a different column at different points in time. You have different clients with different requirements. And so instead of hard coding these values in, what we can do is we can create a dynamic selection instead so that anybody can have whatever they want or whatever you let them have whenever they want to actually see it. So let me close this down and I'm just going to delete out some of this code here. So we have the Star Wars data set and we have, I'm going to start a new select box here. Let me just make this big so you can see all of the code on one screen. So this is all the code we have here. You can see that there's not really much here at all. And I'm going to add a select input and I'm just going to call this select columns. And I'll make the label select columns. And my choices is going to be names Star Wars. This will basically give us all of the column names. And multiple equals to true. So this basically allows us to select multiple items from the drop-down menu. Over here in Star Wars, I'm going to pipe this into select. This basically subsets our columns for us. And input. Okay. Well, effectively, we want to select input and select columns. Now, as mentioned in my previous video, this won't work right now because this is a list of text. And what we want to do is we want to convert these to be column references instead. Now, in order to do that, we use a method called tidyEvaluation. And this is something I go over more in more detail in my course. But if you just want to copy this and use it, all you need to do is type in, three exclamation marks. So in the previous example, I used two exclamation marks. Because you are only selecting a single value. When you're selecting multiple values, you have to add three exclamation marks. And instead of the function rlangsim, that we had in the previous example, I'm using rlangsims. So there we have that there. Okay, let's give that a go. Right, so I have my column over here. I can select name, height, right? And you can see as I click on the columns, they just get added to the data set. It's actually pretty quick because this is a small data set. So every time I click on one of these, it's actually retrieving this data from the server. Right? If I want to delete some of these, I can just come in here, select them, and delete like so. And so this is a really, really neat little feature, very easy to implement if you have something with a lot of columns and you just don't want to see them all or bring back all this data, which is just completely irrelevant to the analysis that you or your user is actually doing. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you want to create your own little dashboards like this, then check out my free sample course at www.datastrategywithjonathan.com. So also just a reminder that I am working on my new master class where I'll be filling it out with tons and tons and tons of great examples. I love the fact that the students are coming back with some really, really great questions, which is really cool because it means I can get into more of the fun, advanced stuff, which is really cool. So please do go check that out. If you found this video helpful, please give a thumbs up. It really helps out a lot to keep the channel going. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you next time.